O-Canada in the books, almost set for the final round robin game. It's the Growlers. It's the Max. Starting goaltenders today, first to our left for the Max, Sam Maggett, Halifax Moosehead pick. 1-0 in this tournament. Picked up a shutout, 30-save shutout yesterday, looking very, very solid. Max have actually won their last two games in this event by shutout. Nathan Mills was solid last night as well against their final second-to-last opponent. At the other end, Scott Kirby, talking about sensational, perhaps robbed of a Player of the Game award yesterday for the Pinnacle Growlers. 45 saves in a loss, was not the Player of the Game. So it looks like this. A win of any kind here for the Max. Currently, they are 2 points behind Steele. So right now, Kensington has clinched. Kensington are first place and in tomorrow's final. That we know 100%. As it stands right now here at Puck Drop, Steel Subaru in second place with 8 points. 2 points ahead of Halifax. So that means a regulation win for Halifax will send them to the final tomorrow against Kensington. An overtime or shootout win will draw them level in points with Steel Subaru for the final spot. So then it'll come down to head-to-head. But Halifax, of course, with the head-to-head over Steel. So for Steel Subaru to make the final against Kensington tomorrow, they need these Pinnacle Growlers to get a regulation or overtime slash shootout win over Halifax. Otherwise, it's a Wild and Max final. Got it? Good. 1 minute gone in this first period. Scoreless and shotless from East Hand Sportsplex. 10th game here over the last 3 days. It's been busy, but it's been a beautiful thing. Aaron Chip sends it far side to Kenzie Wagner. Here's your shot. Goes wide, comes off the boards, and it's in! Well, sometimes they make me look like a genius. I've said ad nauseum through this event that the puck caroms off these end boards here so quickly, and goaltenders need to be aware of it. Not that Scott Kirby wasn't aware of it, but that's what happened there. Puck from Wagner came off the end boards, right out, hit Kirby in the back of the leg and took a terrible bounce and slid over the goal line. You can't help but feel for the Newfoundland netminder there. He looks at the scoreboard, gives his head a shake. But again, it's just one of those bad, unlucky bounces, and much to the chagrin, I'm sure, of the Steel Subaru U18s. 18:44 to go first period, and the Max are already out in front 1-0. Should be Wagner's goal. It'll be his first of the tournament. The captain of the Max. Here comes Michael Skinner now off the draw. Stick to the corner by Maggett. Luke Legere with the only assist on that Kenzie Wagner goal. Max one goal to the good in their quest for a berth in the championship game tomorrow versus Kensington. Skinner now brings it over the blue line. Chips it to Philpott. Philpott tried to get it across. Logan Foote gets in front of that. Foot now. Head to Daniel Walters. Now Luke Dooley has it and brings it over the blue line for the Max. Over to Troy. There did that again. Maddox Marmalak. Kirby sticks that aside. Troy is Maddox's dad, and I know Troy. So second time in this event I've called Maddox Troy Marmalak. That's what happens when you start getting old. You start to know parents of players. Pilgrim lifts this into the Max zone. Maggett to the net. Looked like he was going to lunge at it. Allows to leave it for foot instead, or elects to leave it for foot. Just the one shot in this game, and, well, you know how that ended up. Marmalak. Wrist shot right on. Kirby's got that. Actually, that goal for Wagner technically isn't a shot on goal. Shot went wide of the net. Caromed off the inboards. Here's a quick chance from Hartland. Kirby stops that and pounces on it. He's got three stops. That's the one to remember. when you're doing the stats for the goaltender, it says three shots. Typically, that would mean he's got two saves, but he has three saves because the one goal for the Max was not off of a shot on goal. Riley Creelman now through the slot. Sorry, Proctor comes together with Jack Chafe over there. Lindsay sends it down low. Proctor waits. 3 minutes gone in this first period. Max off to the good start. That takes a funny bounce off the boards on Lindsay and goes the length of the ice. Maggett stops it, sees what Ryland Tilley's going to do, and now he goes this side to Riley Creelman. Here comes Proctor. Can't get through Finley Dobbin. Lindsay brings it over the line onside, but the Growlers take over, wearing their blacks in this one with the gold and white trim. Max in the white with red shoulders and pants and the gold trim. Hartland centers this one for Legere, and he sends that one wide glove side. Wagner. Growlers were changing. Had to hop over the pucks there to avoid a too many men call. Maloney moves us ahead to the Halifax blue line. Truen celebrated his birthday yesterday with a couple wins. Nothing wrong with that. I don't think as this puck slides down on Kirby, he holds it. I don't think if Logan Truen could pick, what do you want for your birthday, son? I think given the time of year and the situation he finds himself in, I think two wins. Well, he would say he would want an Atlantic title. That's what he would say. But to get there, he needed two wins yesterday. So I think he would have taken that just fine. 6-point day for the Max yesterday. And a happy birthday indeed for Logan Truen. Kierley now sends that through the slot. It's off of a foot. Maloney sends it off Chip's glove. Chip gets it back to Wagner. Ahead to Walters. He can't touch that. And no, he must have got a piece because they waved the icing off. Maloney back now to Devereaux. Head to Ben O'Brien. Chips it ahead to Drew Keynes to Kierley. Kierley battling with Faustin. Easton Schlender waits for it on the near side. O'Brien now to the red line. Sends this deep. Foot first to it. To Faustin in the far corner. Faustin is too close to Will Legere with that pass. Legere couldn't find it. Maloney now moves it into his own bench. So that'll be a whistle. 15:02 on the clock. We're almost 5 minutes gone in this final game of the round robin. Shout out to Pro Design Cresting, official sponsor of this game number 10. Five minutes gone, first period. Andy Knight, the Growlers captain, brings it through neutral ice. Now back on the Max. Schlender gets it to Hines. Ethan Hines has that knocked off his stick by Pilgrim. Now Knight can't come up with that clean. This is going to come down wrong goal right on Maggett, and he'll take no chances, and he'll hold it. Shout out to all the Growlers, parents and family and fans watching back on the Rock. So there's quite a bit of you. They've been one of our higher rated teams in terms of viewership through this tournament. No surprise, furthest team away. But the viewership numbers have been steady, consistent, and good throughout. We appreciate each and every one of you who's tuned in. There's a chance in front. Hussey wasn't able to get the redirect. Now Knight from the slot. That's blocked on the way in. Goes back to Knight in the far corner. This is to the point. Patty Gillespie over here for Nathan Pilgrim. Keeps it in. Sends it down low. Creelman lifts this through the middle. Gillespie settles that down. Too far for Knight. Ben Lindsay has it. Lindsay ahead to Walters. Daniel Walters flutters it over to Luke Legere here near blue line. Sends it through. Redirect score! Aaron Chip on a pretty redirect off a nice feed from Luke Legere. 13:45 to go, and it's 2-0 Max. Well, much like we saw with Steele Subaru in the game prior to this, answering the bell when it matters most and you need it. Hard to argue that Halifax hasn't done the same. Young kids playing best when the lights are the brightest. Absolutely love to see it. Chip from Legere. Legere's got his second assist of the period. See if there's a secondary helper, but it's 2-0 max now. But as I said earlier, when we talked about the Growlers in their early game against Kensington, we've seen them down by a couple goals numerous times for this tournament. They always seem to find their way back into the game. And they're going to have to do it again here in this one. Their final game of the season. Jack Chafe now can't get that through. Walters and Legere with the assists on that chip goal. Aaron Chip, a top-ranked prospect for the upcoming Q draft. Now Maddox Marmolak with the toe dragon wrist shot. Seen that 100 times already this week. Good shoulder save by Kirby. Now he makes another stop as Walters spun and fired. Max continuing the pressure on that forecheck. Legere got 2 points in this first period already. Now he's behind the net looking for more. Faustin. Foot shoots. That's tipped down in front by Chip, and that goes just wide. Sorry, that's Dooley. And that goes just wide. It's all Max right now. Here comes Maddox Marmolak. Into the slot, Faustin can't get to it. Noah Boland takes that from him. As we hit the 8-minute mark of period one, Halifax 2, Growlers no score. Boland had 2 goals in game yesterday for the Growlers. It's been quiet since. It's the first of the tournament for Chip. So Wagner's got his first, Chip has his first. We saw guys for the Steel Subaru in the previous game as well. The energy line, namely, like Tucker Mackinnon getting on the board first. He had 2 goals. Ryder McQueen with 2 assists. So they stepped up and got their first points in the biggest game. And now we're seeing it here from Chip and Wagner as well for Halifax. Boland through neutral ice. Over the line, he's got Tilly with him. Boland still with it on the backhand. Banks it back to Maloney at the near point. Maloney down into the slot. Lindsay steps into that. Now slides it ahead to Angus Proctor. Proctor over the blue line. Sends that down on goal. Now Kirby covered it. And just as he plays it, the whistle goes. That's got to be frustrating for the Growlers netminder. 9-2, the shots on goal as it stands in favor of Halifax. And they lead it 2-0. Goals from Wagner and Chip here. 11:03 to go. First period. Pilgrim. Curley on the near boards, giveaway. Now Chip's got it, high slot. Tony McCarthy putting him right back out there. Now here come the Growlers. Curley sweeps that in. Away comes Chip. Try to find Hines. That was in his feet. Now London Opong sends that in. Kirby leaves this for Pilgrim behind the goal. Wagner sends it back in. Max tag up. Kirby takes a bite out of it behind the goal. Now quick shot from Shearer is blocked. Schlender gets it to Hines out front. Can't get the shot away. Penalty coming to the Growlers. Probably going to be a hook. Indeed it is. First power play of the afternoon. Going to the max as Patty Gillespie goes to the box for hooking. Chance to put an early stamp on this one here for Halifax. 10:06 to go, first period. Max to the power play, already leading 2-0. There's a chance at the side. Legere with the shot, stopped by Kirby. Marmolak far side. Q keeps that in the zone nicely as he was being hounded by Hussey, but now finally the Growlers are able to clear. Comes Lindsay now, sends it off the end boards. That's going to come down for Schlender now. To Marmalak. Legere back to Marmalak. Maddox Marmalak. To Legere, sausages it back to Faustin at the point. Faustin shoots, stop. That goes to the corner. Legere over to get that. Back to Maddox Marmalak. Walks off the half board, shoots. That's off a stick. And out of play. 108 to go in the Halifax power play. Looking dangerous so far. Kensington Wild will be the home team and have last change in tomorrow afternoon's championship game. They're going to finish first in the round robin. Nobody's catching them. 10 points through the round robin. 3 regulation wins and an overtime loss. Creelman. Chip walks in. Shot is blocked by Maloney. And Creelman will have to come back into his own zone for it. Under a minute to go in the max power play now. Now Tucker takes that away from Creelman. Tucker walks in, wrist shot right on. Maggett stops that. Still yet to allow a goal in this tournament. Sam Maggett here in his second game. Hartland chases this along with Maloney. 30 seconds to go in the Halifax power play. Chip's got it on the far side. Back to Creelman. Creelman to Hartland. Decides to send that through. Devereaux gets in front of that. Comes back to Hartland now. Gets it to Creelman at the point. 15 seconds on the power play. Chip now skips over Walters' stick. Maloney can't clear. Walters has it in the corner. Back to Chip. Chip to Creelman. Back to Chip. 5 seconds on the power play clock. Walters tried to get over to Hartland. That's intercepted and cleared. The Growlers kill this penalty. 8 minutes to go, first period. Max still leading 2-0, though. Goals from Kenzie Wagner and Aaron Chip. Legere with a pair of assists already. Devereaux through neutral ice with speed, drops it. In comes Tucker. His stick was hit just as he was shooting. Wasn't able to get any kind of release there. Now Nolan Avery chops this forward. Devereaux can't keep it in the zone. Pinnacle Growlers trying to avoid becoming the only winless team in this tournament. Every other team has a win here in East Hants this week. Avery, tonight! That shot came off of his stick funny, kind of wobbled wide of the near post. That would have been a dangerous shot had he got all of it and had he been accurate with it. Pilgrim keeps it in at the near point. Knight gets a step on. Turner shoots off the side of the post, trying to go high, short side. I like Knight. Knight's a good player. He's got a good stride. He's got good hands. Amherst Rambler pick from the Maritime Hockey League. Whether we ever see him in Amherst is another thing, as this was offside, came out over the blue line. It's hard to get some of these guys from Newfoundland to come over and play junior hockey here in the Maritimes. They've got a great junior B league over there. Senior hockey, of course, as vibrant as ever on the rock. Best senior league in Atlantic Canada. Really. 12-3 shots on goal in favor of the Max, and their full value for the 2-0 lead that they currently enjoy. Jack Chafe sends it far side to Reed Chafe, and he'll lift it in. It's Magic directing traffic down there. Truen gets it over to Wagner, slides it ahead to Chip. Marmalak through neutral ice with speed, gets it right on the tape. Now he puts it through the legs of Dobbin. Marmalak trying to find Legere. Oh, a little too unselfish there for Maddox Marmalak. He passed up a good shot to try and get it to his linemate, Luke Legere, and he put it behind him. Marmalak would like that one back, I think it's safe to say. Now Legere on the bench saying, it's okay, man. Faceoff will come to the left of Scott Kirby in the Growlers' goal. Fans of Steel Subaru surely watching this one either here or online. Praying for a Growlers comeback. Skinner Chafe takes a hit up high. That looked like a hit to the head. Neither referee sees it. Trevor Budgell on the Growlers bench can't believe it. That looked like a clear blow to the head. Budgell still giving it to the officials. Shearer slides it through. Hines to the backhand. Good pad save, Kirby. Now Shearer with a chance. Kirby stops that. What a save. Two saves for Kirby. Shearer now to Schlender. Schlender slides it over. Lindsay shoots. Kirby gets a piece of that. Frantic action here now. But again, remember that. Reed Chafe was hit on that far side of the blue line, and that most certainly looked like a blow to the head, and both referees, not one but two, missed it. Maloney now from the point. That doesn't get through. Creelman gives chase along with Tilly. Tilly cycles it down low for Micah Tucker. Tucker to Tilly. Tilly with a shot. That flutters wide. Boland. Ben Lindsay in to take that from him. Micah Tucker to the corner. Trying to get it back to the point. Now he's going to cycle it down low. Noah Boland will lift that down. Riley Creelman takes over. Puck is rolling a bit. Now Devereaux steps in front of Schlender. Growlers get it back temporarily. Schlender's going to skate it out himself this time. Under 5 to go, first period. Shots on goal, 13-3 in favor of the Max. Now this stretch pass by Scott Kirby looking for Ryland Tilly. He's quick, but he's not that quick. Icing called on the Growlers. 4:40 to go, first period. Again, a win of any kind by the Max sends them to tomorrow's championship game against the Kensington Wild. Steel Subaru need a Growlers victory. Legere and Boland in on this draw to the right of Kirby. One by the Max. Faustin. Legere takes that. He's got two assists in this first period. There's a redirect by Hartland. Might have caught a piece of the post. Stays in play. Now Faustin almost fell. Regains composure. Legere fires it high and wide. Foot at the far point. Down low for Hartland. Hartland being hounded by Maloney down there. Now Angus Proctor races over to the near side. Proctor down low. That's taken by Boland. He's towards the end of his shift, so he's probably looking for an outlet and then a line change. 4 minutes to go, first period. Proctor over to Foot. Logan Foot slides it through to Legere. Got Hartland and Proctor with him. Proctor shoots. Blocker save Kirby. Kenzie Wagner over for it. Shoots right on. Pad save Kirby. Big rebound. Proctor sends that wide on the backhand. Patty Gillespie now back to the point. Racing over to keep it in is Wagner. He'll send it down low. Patty Gillespie takes over for the Growlers. Gillespie to Drew Kane. Sidesteps the check of Wagner. Now Truen swipes at it. Noah Boland brings in. He's still out there. This has been a long shift for Noah Boland. Walters has it here in front of his own bench. Max changing. Walters by himself right now. Gillespie. Through the middle. That's an intercept by Marmolak. And he was almost in all alone on Kirby. Back comes Nathan Pilgrim. He's got O'Brien and Keynes with him. Whistle goes on the offside at the far blue line. Growlers, much like we saw earlier this morning against Kensington, just having trouble getting anything going. Zone entries have been a problem. Offense has been a problem. 16-3, shots on goal in favor of Halifax. 3:04 to go, first period. Growlers control off the draw. Gillespie sends this one in off a stick, and that goes over the end glass and out of play. So we'll do it again. This one might come inside the zone, though. Officials talking about it, saying, where are we going to put this face off? It's going to come back out into neutral ice. Walters and O'Brien do the honors. Walters wins that cleanly back to Wagner. He gets it over to Truen. Truen to Wagner. Up ahead to Marmolak. Couldn't come up with that clean. Now Walters and Kearley come together. Wagner's got it at his own blue line. Over to Luke Dooley, the middle Sackville Nova Scotia native. Ahead to Marmolak. Marmolak overskates that. Walters was offside as a result. And another stoppage. Both teams make some changes to their personnel here. 2:42 to go. First period. Appreciate y'all watching on AO Live. Final game of the round robin. We've got one game after this. And as much as I'm loving it, my throat needs a break. But hey, I'd do it again next weekend if I had the opportunity. Jack Chafe over to Finley Dobbin. Too far for Nolan Avery. Now back comes Luke Legere. One on three, trying to get around Chafe. Good stick lift by Chafe, and Andy Knight takes over, the Growlers captain. Knight chipped ahead by Hussey. Creelman's got it here in neutral ice. He'll send it back in. Max had to tag up. Finley Dobbin over to Jack Chafe. He looks for an outlet across the middle. Finds O'Brien. Sorry, Avery. Now Hussey's got it. Hussey with speed over the blue line. Goes wide on Lindsay. Lindsay with a good stick. Moncton Wildcats pick. Ben Lindsay breaks that play up. Now back comes Turner. Ahead to Legere. Legere one-on-one with Jack Chafe. Legere goes wide behind the goal. Still with it, Legere. Finds Walter Skull. No. Yes, it is a goal. You never know with these posts here. Daniel Walters with a one-timer. Third assist of the period for Luke Legere. And they're off to the races. It's 3-0. Just under 2 minutes to go. First period. Walters has his third of the tournament. Legere has his third assist of the period. That one just went off the inside of the post and in. And it's 3-0 Max in this must-win game. Walters in, shoots, that goes wide. Walters showing why he's so highly touted for the upcoming Q draft. 3 goals in this tournament as we wait for the goal announcement here. Chip with an assist as well. He's got a goal and an assist in this first period. .120 to go, and this one pops up near, stays in play. Thought it was going to go into the Halifax bench. Foot now back for it. Foot ahead to Oppong. London Oppong over the blue line. Sends it in. That's right on Kirby, and he'll stop it. Hold it. 16 saves. I got to remember that first goal was not off of a shot on goal. 16 saves in this first period for Scott Kirby. He's been busy, much like he was yesterday. Under a minute to go in the first now. Growlers trying to clear. They do, but it goes into the bench, so they're going to have to face it off inside their own zone again with 52 seconds on the clock. Shearer now trying to get down to that corner. Noah Boland there to pick that up. Boland back to Pilgrim. Stretch pass looking for Tilly. Now the foot race. Thought Tilly might have won that race, but they're going to give it to Wagner. So that's going to be another icing call on the Growlers. Come back down and do it again in the Growler zone. 35 seconds to go, first period. Shearer wins that draw ahead, but there to collect that and skate it out is Micah Tucker. 30 seconds to go in the period. Tucker over the blue line. Still with it. Micah Tucker shoots. Magic steers that aside. Tilly now. Brought out by Ethan Hines. Hines, 3-on-3 here for the Max. Shearer has that taken from him by Gillespie. Shearer gets it back. 10 seconds left in the period. Lindsay from the point, changes the direction on the way, and it's still loose. They whack away. Another chance for Hines. Kirby kicks that out, and the period is going to end right there. 20-4. The shots on goal in favor of the Max through 20 minutes of play. And your score after one period in Game 10, the final round-robin game of this 2024 Atlantics. The Halifax Max, in a game they need to win, lead the Pinnacle Growlers by a score of 3-0. The host committee would like to thank Pro Design Cresting, the official sponsor of this game number 10. We're going to pause for the first intermission. We'll come back in about 13 minutes' time. Run down the scoring summary from the first, tee up the second. You are watching the 2024 U18 AAA Atlantic Hockey Championships on AO Live. Welcome back. East Hand Sportsplex. Teams are on the ice. Officials are on the ice. 3-0. Halifax Max leading the Pinnacle Growlers after one period of play in the final round-robin game of the 2024 U18 AAA Atlantic Hockey Championships. Mike Barkhouse and Ashton Rieke along with you here on AO Live. Appreciate y'all for being with us. Scoring summary from that first period. Obviously, three Max goals. First one came Kenzie Wagner, his first of the tournament. A heavy slap shot that caromed off the end boards, hits the back of Scott Kirby's skate and slid over the line. Gave the Max a 1-0 lead. Then Aaron Chipp would score his first of the tournament. Sorry, Legere with the assist on that Wagner goal, I should say. Then Aaron Chipp, his first of the tournament from Legere and Walters. Made it 2-0 Halifax. And then Walters would score his third of the tournament from Legere and Chipp to make it 3-0 Max. So three assists in that first period for Luc Legere, a goal and an assist for Chipp, and a goal and an assist for Walters. Shots on goal in that first period, 20-4 in favor of Halifax. Halifax 0-for-1 on the power play in that period. Growlers did not have an opportunity. That gets you teed up for the second again. A win of any kind today here for Halifax, and they go to the final tomorrow versus Kensington. Steel Subaru U18 fans watching, praying for a Pinnacle Growlers comeback. The deficit can't grow much more than this if they're going to make a comeback, I'll tell you that. There we go. Legere with his three assists already. He's challenging now for the tournament scoring lead with those three assists. Coming into today, Ethan Dixon. Well, now it's updated. So currently, Ethan Dixon and Liam Arsenal of Kensington are 1 and 2 in scoring with 10 points and 7 points, respectively. Luc Legere now has 6. So if he can continue to do well here in this one, he's getting awful close to Liam Arsenal for second. Dixon, though, might not be able to be caught. We got a penalty here early in the second to the Max. So early second period power play here for the Growlers. Might this be the recipe for the beginning of a comeback? 22 seconds into the period, and there's a power play for the Growlers. Dobbin tonight. Shot right on. Catches Magic by surprise, but he's good positionally, and he stops it. O'Brien tonight. Knight can't get the shot away. Finally does, but it's blocked. Now Avery's got it to Dobbin. Nolan Avery, top of the circle. Backdoor feed to Knight. Then one pass too many. Knight passes up the shot. Tried to find O'Brien at the side of the net. O'Brien now over to Knight. Dobbin. 30 seconds gone in the Growlers' man advantage. Avery far side. Down low to O'Brien. O'Brien to Dobbin. Over to Knight. Blocked by Truin. Good block there by the Max defender. Knight to Tucker. Back to Dobbin. Wrist shot through traffic. It's loose. They don't know where it is now. Magic finds it. Knight has a chance at the side. Can't jam it in. Great power play here for the Growlers. They've done everything but score. Tucker can't get to that. It's rimmed around, and it does come out. 1 minute to go in the Growlers' power play. Kirby out of the net. Plays it to Nolan Avery on the far side. Avery slides it to Dobbin. Dobbin gets it to Reed Chafe. He sends it deep. Giving chase is Skinner. Now racing over is Devereaux. He's not going to be able to keep that in. 40 seconds to go in the power play. Nick Devereaux drops it for Jack Chafe. Chafe gets the blue line, sends it deep. Maggett out of the net. Still has not allowed a goal in this tournament, Sam Maggett. Halifax Mooseheads have to be happy with what they're seeing from him. Noah Boland back to Chafe. 15 seconds to go on the power play. Devereaux walks in, shoots. That goes high glove side. Big shot from Devereaux there. Chafe ahead to Boland. Boland lugs it over the blue line. Back to Chafe. Penalty is ending. Max kill it off. Both teams now 0-for-1 on the power play this afternoon. Foot Pokes this ahead to Schlender. And he'll knock that off the boards and out. Not going to go far enough for icing. Kirby comes out to play it, trying to catch the match in a change. 3-on-1 here. There's a shot through. Boland can't get the redirect on goal. That was a golden opportunity. A 3-on-1 for the Growlers. Heads up play by Scott Kirby to send that pass up, knowing the Macs are changing. Created that 3-on-2. Boland wasn't able to convert. Now Chafe fans on it in front of goal. Will Shearer pokes that ahead to Marmalak. Knocked right back out by Pilgrim. Creelman. Head to Marmalak. Creelman. Choppy play there at the blue line. Now Marmalak away with it. Hines gives that away. That comes Knight with speed. Knight trying to go wide on Creelman. Pulls it ahead to his forehand. Comes around. Still with it is Andy Knight. Knight still with it. Shoots, and then it's off a stick of Marmalak and over the glass. Just 6 shots on goal so far for the Growlers in this one. 16-16 to go, second period. Walters brings it ahead. He's got a goal and an assist in one. He's got 3 goals in the tournament. Legitimate Quebec League prospect for the upcoming draft. Here comes Luke Dooley. He's got Chip going to the net. Dooley sends that through. Pad save by Kirby. Penalty coming to the Growlers as Chip was dumped on the far side. It's going to be an interference call. This is going to stunt the comeback efforts a bit. Looks like it's Nolan Avery heading off for interference. Second power play of the afternoon for Halifax about to begin. It's 15:46 to go, second period. Must kill for the Growlers. Boston to Marmalak. Can't get that through. Halifax can't keep it in as the Growlers clear to the red line. Foston now brings it over the blue line to Marmalak. Marmalak to Foston. Back to Marmalak. Head of lane. Gets it down low to Legere. Shoots. And that's stopped and held by Kirby. Kirby continues to be busy. 26 seconds gone in the penalty. 1:34 to go in the Halifax power play. Something about that face-off the linesman didn't like. Legere giving the boot. Marmalak in to take. Now we're having all kinds of trouble getting this one dropped. Maybe some time came off the clock. Not sure what that was all about. I think we're ready to get underway now, though. Marmalak wins it back to Lindsay, over to Foston. Connor Foston walks to the middle, sounds it down low for Legere. Marmalak shot, taken up high by Kirby. Rebound is there. Backs couldn't jam it home. Marmalak now, near point. Down low for Legere. Back to Marmalak, to Foston. Marmalak. Foston. Marmalak. Sends it through, looking for a redirect. Hit a skate of Devereaux. Oftentimes that gets redirected on goal. This time it did not. About a minute to go in this Halifax power play. Maloney trying to clear. Growlers cannot. Lindsay to Schlender, back to Lindsay. Lindsay over here for Marmalak. Marmalak leaves it for Foston. Backdoor feed to Lindsay. Lindsay shoots, that goes wide. You got all of that. And it's gonna go all the way down into the Halifax territory. 40 seconds to go on the power play. Lindsay on the far side, brings it in over the blue line. Now he's gonna try and beat Maloney. He sends it over for Hartland. Hartland couldn't take that on his backhand. Growler's clear. Under 30 seconds to go on the power play. Magic plays it over to Truen. Truen plays it back to Walters. Daniel Walters to Hartland. Head for Dooley. That's knocked back to Hartland. And he'll skate it through neutral ice now. Jacob Hartland sends that deep. Dooley leaves it for Walters. 5 seconds to go on the power play. Looks like the Growlers are going to kill it off. Dooley out the near side. Still with it. Gets it back to Truen. Truen to Chip. Chip sends it through. Dooley tried for the redirect. Kirby's got it. So now we'll reset. Now that we're back to 5-on-5, 22-6 in shots on goal in favor of Halifax. They've locked it down. 13:39 to go, second period. 2-0 Halifax leading, 3-0, sorry. Halifax leading the Growlers. Proctor taking to the ice. Andy Knight has it on the far side. Sends it over here. Nobody in black or white for that matter. Wagner races up to get it. Sends it down low. Kirby out of the net to stop it. But he plays it right to Hines on the far in the far corner. Hines centers. Goes to Nolan Avery. Now he gives it away to Proctor. Proctor makes a nice move. Proctor's still with it. Now Wagner gets it at the near point. Wrist shot. That's redirected by Hines off to the far side. He pool cued that one. Proctor. That was behind Shearer off of a stick. Hines. Now Shearer walks in. Tried to pass it across. That's off a body. Now Avery's got it. Trying to send Knight away. Needed to maybe take a little bit more time there. Icing on the Growlers. 12:43 on the clock. Winner of this goes to the TELUS Cup. A couple weeks' time in Member 2, April 22nd to 28th, in that great facility up there. And I don't mean the winner of this game, obviously. I mean the winner of this tournament, the winner of tomorrow's championship game. What we do know is whoever it ends up being, it's going to be a great representative of the Atlantic region. That's a super competitive tournament, though. One that, you know, there was a time 10 or so years ago, even longer ago than that, where the thought of a team from here winning that event was basically unheard of. The Cape Breton West Islanders changed that back in 2016, I think it was. And then more recently, the Moncton Flyers, who had a disappointing week here in East Hants, winning that event. Jack Martin of the Halifax Mooseheads scoring the overtime winning goal for the Flyers in that. So we've had a couple Atlantic region winners in recent times. We had a winner out of Quebec. It was an all-Quebec final last year. Now a penalty coming to Halifax as O'Brien is dumped. A sloppy tripping call there to Connor Faustin. And the Growlers going back to the man advantage with 11:37 to go in the second. This will be their second power play of the period and of the afternoon. Another chance to cut into the Halifax lead. You can hear the cheers from the Steel Subaru supporters. You can hear them from here, can't you? You can hear you through the screen. O'Brien with a quick shot. Good save by Magic. He had to be alert there. Last Growlers power play didn't result in a goal, but lots of great puck movement and possession. Let's see what they can do here. Boland back to Nick Devereaux. Over to Dobbin. Finley Dobbin. Through the middle. Skinner gets it back to Dobbin. Dobbin tried to find O'Brien. Boland's got it now. Back to Devereaux. Devereaux, quick pass to Skinner. Michael Skinner to Boland. Absorbs the contact from Legere. Gets it back to Devereaux at the point. Devereaux, snapshot. That hits a leg and goes to the corner. Lindsay first to it. Can't chip it past Boland. Now Creelman's got it down low. Tries to pin it to the wall and kill some clock. Skinner tries to dig it loose. They do. O'Brien gets it to Boland. Back to Devereaux at the far point. Power play is almost half over. Boland on the half boards. Back to Devereaux. Devereaux to Dobbin. Cross ice feed. Skinner tries to get it on goal. Does. Madgett stops it and holds it. And now Creelman takes Skinner aggressively to the ice. And they have some words as they get back to their feet. ...55 seconds to go in the Growlers' power play. Face off to the left of Madgett, who's still perfect in this tournament. Wagner off the draw. Sends it into the feet of Jack Chafe. Chafe gives it away, and now Easton Schlender the other way, shorthanded. On the backhand, goes to the net. It's into the chest of Kirby, and he'll hold it. Good save there from the Growlers' netminder. ...42 seconds to go in the Growlers power play. And they'll have to start from their own end here. They win the draw, though. That's step one. Andy Knight through neutral ice. Cuts outside. Andy Knight pulls it to the forehand. Shot right on. Madgett stops it. Schlender will get this out. 20 seconds to go. Kirby out of the net to play it. He's really comfortable doing that. He'll leave it for Avery. Nolan Avery. One last rush up ice perhaps on this power play for the Growlers. Pulling inside is Micah Tucker. He's bodied out the puck and the penalty comes to a close. Now looking for out of the box is Faustin and he's got it. Faustin in all alone. Faustin to the backhand. Good save, Kirby. Perhaps a game saver there from Scott Kirby as Connor Faustin out of the box in all alone. Went to the backhand. Kirby stayed with him. Philpott tries to leave it for Avery down there. Now here comes Angus Proctor. Proctor, he's got Legere going to the net. Peels off. Proctor back to Lindsay. Lindsay. Wrist shot through traffic, redirected off the top of the net. And you hear some oohs from the crowd. Foot from the point. That's stopped and held by Kirby. Continues to do good work. 24 saves for Kirby in this one so far. No goals in this period. All three goals in this hockey game came in the first. Legere from the top of the circle right on. Might have been going wide. Kirby takes no chances and gloves it. Max win another draw. Hartland. Philpott steps in front of that, and away come the Growlers. Philpott lifts it out to neutral ice. Foot skates it in over the blue line. Logan Foot gets it to Legere behind the goal. Three assists for him in this game. Legere pulls it through the legs nicely. They try and jam it away at the side. Kirby keeps it out. It was loose in the crease for a moment. Gillespie gets it out of harm's way. Pilgrim rims it around. Skinner chips it out. Proctor first to it. Settles that rolling puck down. Now gets it over here looking for Foot. Foot's got to retreat for it. And he'll send it far side for Proctor. That skips over his stick by the Zamboni gate. Pilgrim sends it off a leg. Not sure if Reed Chafe will be able to keep this in or not. The answer is no. Gillespie ahead to Reed Chafe. Pokes it to Foot. Max takeover. Faustin to the red line. Sends it in. Now Kirby plays it to Skinner. Skinner ahead to Reed Chafe. Reed Chafe to Hussey. Hussey goes wide, tried to center for Chafe. That's broken up by Krim. And Max have put on a defensive clinic here this afternoon against the Growlers. And now this one's sent up and over the glass and out of play by Walters. 28-9, the shots on goal in favor of Halifax. Just 9 shots on goal for the Growlers here. As we near the 13-minute mark of the second period. 7:21 to go. Max by three. And they're looking to make it more. Dooley over the blue line. Stops up. Back to Creelman. Creelman over to Lindsay. Shoots that one. That hits a stick on the way in and sails over the goal. Creelman sends that on goal. Stopped by Kirby. Delayed penalty coming to Halifax, I believe. Yeah, it's going to be Halifax. It's going to be a tripping call. And it's going to be Luke Dooley off for tripping. Third Growlers penalty, sorry, power play of this second period. They've been unable to get anything by Madgett. He hasn't been busy by any stretch. I can't mislead you. Dobbin has the Growlers control off the draw. Over to Avery. He's got some room. Avery. Dobbin. Knight. That skips on him. Tucker gets it back tonight. And now that's cleared. Away comes Shearer. 2-on-1 with Hines shorthanded. Shoot stop by Kirby. Back comes Avery. Avery. Try to get it across. That came off of his stick funny, and Magic pins it against his pad and holds it. 1:27 to go in the power play. Back to Avery at the point. Gets it over to Knight. Knight shoots. That's right on. Magic's got that, and he pounces on the rebound before a black sweater could get to it. Devereaux. Tonight, turns and fires, redirected, hops up into the glove of Magic. Good puck possession, and they're getting pucks on goal, but just unable to get by Magic. They just need one chance that's a little bit more higher grade. 1:08 to go in the Growlers power play. This one's cleared and skips over Devereaux's stick. Avery spins away from Chip, who's forechecking shorthanded. Devereaux to Avery to Knight. He'll send it in. 40 seconds to go on the power play. Magic stops that. Now plays it off of Stanchion. And the Max clear. Kirby takes that behind the goal, leaves it for Devereaux. And there's Turner giving Devereaux trouble, and Turner takes it from Devereaux. Kane's trying to get it back, and he does. Now Kirby's going to play it. Devereaux. 10 seconds to go in the Growlers' power play. Looks like the Max are going to kill off a third successive penalty in this second period. Here comes Jack Chafe. Through to O'Brien. Ran out of real estate, got too tight on goal, and his quick release shot went well wide. Boland trying to find it for a shot. Can't. Now away comes Shearer. Over to Legere. So that's Schlender. Shearer sends the shot on goal. Now foot. Down low. Legere brings it out front. Could get a shot away. Schlender tries. That doesn't get through. And now O'Brien skates it out. Slides it over to Devereaux over the blue line. Nick Devereaux cuts into the middle. Still with it. Nick Devereaux shoots that nowhere near the net. Might have hit something. It did hit something, and that's why the faceoff's going to stay in the defensive zone. 4:23 to go, second period. Back underway, Proctor. And low. Legere. Centering pass, looking for Hartland. That pops up in the air. Legere looking for his fourth assist, of the hockey game. 4 minutes to play, second period. Max have got this one locked down right now, but things can change. We all know that. We've all seen enough hockey. Reed Chafe shoots through the legs of the defender, Lindsay, right on. Magic stops that. Now back comes Hartland with speed. Hartland tried to get through to Proctor. That doesn't connect. Now Creelman keeps it in. Tries to get to Legere. That's off of Chafe and out. Max will have to flee the zone. Marmalak gloves that ahead. That's going to be a glove pass, unless, and there it is. Pilgrim touches it to negate that. Truen, with 3 minutes to go in the second, gets it to Wagner over the blue line. He's got a goal here. Wagner sends it on Kirby. And he'll stop it. A little pushing and shoving after that. It's pretty innocent. Wagner looked, angled it like he was going to reach in for a poke. He didn't really do anything. But you can understand the sensitivity and the frustration of the Growlers. This tournament has not gone how they had hoped. We certainly liked having them here, though. Our friends from the Rock are some of the best human beings you'll ever meet in your life. Walters sends that off a body to the corner. Look, nice play by Dooley. He scores! What a goal from Luke Dooley. He did a triple sal cow and in one motion fired it through the legs of Kirby, catching him by surprise. I don't know if that's Elvis Stoiko or Luke Dooley. I know I'm dating myself with that figure skating reference. I don't want to hear about it. 4-0 Max. 2:47 to go. Dooley has worked hard all tournament. Good to see him get that. Try and get the announcement for you here. Walters with the only assist. So that's Walters' third point of the day. He's got a goal and two helpers. He and Legere both with three-point afternoons. The shot right on. Kirby's got another save, and there's a penalty coming here on this play. At least one, maybe more. Schlender and Avery are in conversation. It's going to be Schlender heading off for interference. Fourth power play of the period for the Growlers. So I guess if you're looking for Tony McCarthy, if you're looking for something to, maybe harp on your team about an intermission when they think everything's sunshine and roses, what's this? They've given up four power plays in this second period. That's not going to get it done in a final. First of the tournament for Luke Dooley. Third point of the day for Walters. So here we go. Can the Growlers finally crack the code that is Sam Maggett? They control off the draw. Boland lost the puck when he was going to pass it. Kept in nicely by Dobbin at the far point to Boland. This will chew up just about the remainder of the second period. There's about 4 seconds in difference. That shot is stopped by Maggett as it hit a couple things on the way in. Tucker's got it far corner. Tucker to Dobbin. Dobbin to Chafe. Chafe shoots. That changes direction. I think had it got on goal without the redirect, it might have found its way to the top corner. The redirect is almost worse, even though it caught Magic by surprise and he had to change direction. Now here's a giveaway. Proctor in shorthanded. Gets the shot away, stopped, and he draws a penalty. That's going to do it for the Growlers power play. Going to have some four-on-four hockey for a minute 11, and then a brief max power play to follow. Dobbin to the box. Tied up Proctor. Preventing a good scoring chance there shorthanded. Thirty-two saves already for Scott Kirby. Might well end up with more saves than he did yesterday. Growlers control off the draw. 4-on-4 for the remainder of the second period. Actually, no. Max power play will begin with 4 seconds left in this second period. Ben O'Brien gets tied up in the Zamboni. Treads, and away comes Legere. Legere's got Hartnell with him. It's delayed offside as Hartnell was a little bit ahead of the play there. Gillespie too far for Canes. They're going to call that icing on the Growlers. And they'll skate all the way back to the other end. 46.8 to go, second period. One by the Max. Wagner over to Truen. To Wagner. Wagner rush up. Blocker saved by Curry, but to put the rebound right in the slot for Truen. Growler's scrambling, trying to get it out of harm's way. Legere's got it now. Pulls it around Pilgrim. Wagner. Over to Truen. Now Gillespie steps in front of this as it was sent down low. 20 seconds left in the period. Wagner's got it in neutral ice. Wagner sends it deep. Pilgrim chips that past Canes. Canes ahead to O'Brien. 1-on-2, 5 seconds left in the period. Canes over the blue line. Canes fires it down low, and that will do it for period two. Buzzer goes to end the first 40 minutes. Shots on goal through two periods of play. 36-15 in favor of Halifax. And your score after 40 minutes. Game 10, final game of the round robin here at the 2024 Atlantics. The Halifax Max 4, the Pinnacle Growlers no score. The host committee would like to thank Pro Design Cresting, official sponsor of this game number 10. We're going to pause for the second intermission. Come back in about 13 and a half minutes time. Tee up the third for you. The finish of the round robin is next. You're watching the 2024 U18 AAA Atlantic Hockey Championships on AO Live. Welcome back to East Hants. One period remains in the round robin. Halifax Max 20 minutes away from a berth in tomorrow's Atlantic Championship final against the Kensington Wild. Mike Barkhouse and Ashton Rieke with you here on AO Live. Thank you for joining us all week long, today, whatever the case may be. 4-0 Max after two. This is how we got there. Three goals in the first period for Halifax. Kenzie Wagner opened the scoring early. His first of the tournament. Luke Legere with the assist made it 1-0 Max. Aaron Chipp would then score his first of the tournament. Legere with another assist. Daniel Walters with an assist as well. It was 2-0 Halifax. Then Walters would get on the scoring act, scoring his third of the tournament. Legere with his third assist of the period. Chipp with an assist as well. 3-0 Halifax after one. Shots on goal after one. 20-4 in favor of Halifax. Just one goal in the second period. Luke Dooley, the Middle Sackville native, gets his first of the tournament. Walters with an assist. So, 4-0 Max after two. Legere with three assists. Walters with a goal and two assists. Chipp with a goal and an assist. They're well on their way to the championship game tomorrow. What a tilt that will be if it is indeed Kensington versus Halifax. Shots on goal through 40 minutes. 36-15 in favor of the Max. Scott Kirby in the Pinnacle Growlers goal, as he was yesterday. It's been fantastic. Max 0 for 3. I'll get that right. 0 for 3 on the power play today. Growlers with four power play opportunities in that second period. Came up empty. And actually, the Max currently are on a power play to start this third period. 45 seconds remains in it. That's all I got. Back underway. Halifax power play to begin the third. Again, just 40 seconds or so left in it. Here comes Legere. If they can get one more, that'll just about ice it. Officially. Calling it. Fostin to Marmalak. Back to Fostin. To Lindsay, shot right on, and Kirby snares that with the glove. ...25 seconds left in the Halifax power play now. Schlender's got it, sends it back to Lindsay at the point, over to Fostin. Fostin to Lindsay. To Fostin. Boston, backdoor feed to Legere. That shot goes wide. Lindsay in to take it from Devereaux. Gets it back to Fostin. Fostin to Marmalak. Marmalak to Legere to Lindsay. That just goes wide. Marmalak with a chance. It hits the post. Growlers hang on. Kill it off. Halifax 0 for 3 on the power play now. Now Avery picks it up. Had a chance to meet his dad during the second intermission. Now Magic takes one off the mask, I believe. And now Lindsay and Tucker exchanging summer plans. Down in the crease at the side of the Halifax goal. Just past the 1 minute mark of the third, 18:57 to go. That's how close the Max are to a date with the Kensington Wild tomorrow afternoon at 1 p.m. Atlantic time. Walters and Hussey in on this draw. Hussey wins it back to Pilgrim. Nathan Pilgrim sends that through. Gloved down by Truen. Head to Walters. Walters to Hartland. Hartland. It's off a Chipp stick and off the side glass. Chipp out the near side. Back to Truen. Hartland. Now Knight has it. Chipp watching him. Pilgrim to Gillespie. He slides ahead to Avery. Avery. Gillespie knocks this down low. Hussey after that. Walters pokes it away from him. 2 minutes gone in the third period. Hussey. Knight shot, that's off a Truen skate and wide, or shin pad, take your pick. Avery tonight, high slot. Wrist shot, that sails over the goal. Avery's got it. Nice hand-eye coordination there to take it off the glass. Knight. Now Truen in to take that away. Truen, that puck sticks a little bit in the water, so he has to drag it from behind. Now he gets it forward. Now here comes Hussey. In all alone on Maggett. Hussey shoots. Pad save by Maggett. Rebound comes back to Hussey. Hines takes that from him. Now tries to find Proctor and does. Just onside. I don't know. I think he might have been in ahead of the puck, but no video review here. So it's going to be ruled an onside. Final answer. Proctor. Try to get it back to the point. That hits the referee. Now Shearer has it behind the goal. It's knocked away from him. Hussey back to the point. Creelman keeps it in. Sends it towards goal. Scores! Will Shearer with the redirect on the doorstep. Makes it 5-0 Halifax. Good to see Will Shearer join the party. His first of the tournament. .17:03 to go in the third, and you would think that should just about do it. We'll wait to see if we can hear the assists. There will be assists. Probably even two. Marmalak's got it. Now gets it back to Wagner. Wagner's shot stopped by Kirby, and he'll hold it, and he'll chop Marmalak's stick for a shovel. Kirby's feisty. Wagner and Proctor, it sounds like. Wagner and Proctor with the assists on Will Shearer's first of the tournament. 35 saves for Scott Kirby in this one, and there's still 16:40 to go. Dooley comes back to Wagner. Kremlin's got it. Kremlin far side for Marmalak. The slot for Dooley. Shot kicked out by Kirby. Turner back to the point to Kremlin. Shot gets through. They score. Did Dooley tip that? I think he did. Luke Dooley's got his second of the day, second of the tournament. 6-0 max. And now, well, you know what? I'll wait till the face-off. Dooley's a good kid, and it's good to see him get rewarded here, much like we saw Tucker Mackinnon in the game previous. As I mentioned, second of the game, second of the tournament for Luke Dooley. Max firmly in control now. I think we can almost call it a Max Wild final tomorrow. Gillespie has trouble finding this. Just going to get the goal announcement here and pause for a moment. Creelman and Turner with assists. Nice to see Turner get on the scoreboard and Creelman as well for that matter. So what I was going to say before I cut myself off, I mentioned this in the previous game, Kensington against Pinnacle, first thing this morning. At what point does Tony McCarthy now, the Halifax bench boss, start resting his guys? You know you're going to the final tomorrow. You don't want anyone to pick up an injury or do something silly and get a suspension here in the final 15 and a half minutes. Do you start to say, hey, Luke Legere, Maddox Marmalak, Daniel Walters, Ben Lindsay, guys like that, do you start to say, hey, that's enough, you guys. You guys can take a rest for the rest of the game. Probably not a bad idea. We saw a little bit, I asked the question earlier of Nathan DeRoche, Kensington coach, and we saw it for the most part. There was a shift where Eddie Doyle came out on the power play. There was a shift where Liam Arsenault came out quickly and Ethan Dixon on a power play, but they were only out there for about one shift or two shifts after I said that. Delayed penalty coming to Halifax here. So we wonder, as they touch the puck and the whistle goes, it's going to be a hit to the head penalty. Growler's about to go back to the power play. But just to finish that thought, it definitely needs to be considered. I talked about it, and I equated it to level of risk tolerance when you're investing. Some guys are highly risk tolerant and will high risk all the way. Some are no risk at all. Some are somewhere in the middle. If I were a hockey coach at this level, I don't think I would risk having my top guys out there in a 6-0 game knowing I have a final tomorrow, an Atlantic final at that. I want to make sure I got all my guns available to me. So we'll see what Tony McCarthy does here in the final stretch. Fifth Growlers power play is underway. Schlender's got it. He's going to get it to Walters. He'll send this deep. Maloney out the near side. Minute and a half to go in the power play. That's off Tilly. Walters sends it deep. Kirby ahead to Boland. Boland cuts inside. Noah Boland still with it. Tilly now, top of the circle shot. Easy save for Magic, steering that to the corner. And now Kirby's got it. Devereaux almost blows a tire. Under a minute to go in the power play now. Knight. Over the blue line. Hussey. Ridden down by Wagner. That's going to be a penalty on Kenzie Wagner as he basically jumped on Hussey's back like he was a horse and rode him to the corner. So it's going to be a 34-second 5-on-3 for the Growlers. Chance to get the first puck past Sam Maggett in this tournament. And we've got a timeout here now for Trevor Budgell and the Growlers. Trying to draw something up and take advantage of this power play time. 13 and a half to go in the third. So they've put a couple seconds on that, well, both the game clock and the penalty clock. It's actually 36 seconds now to go in the first minor. So 36 seconds of 5-on-3 time for the Growlers. And then a good chunk of time on another 5-on-4. Magic figures to be tested here now. Max control and rim it around off the draw. That's going to kill some time off the 5-on-3. Kirby out to the corner to give it to Jack Chafe. Knight with speed through neutral ice. Knight centers for Hussey. Magic stops that. Hussey gets it right back. Down low for Knight. Trades places with Dobbin. Drops it for Avery. Avery shoots, stop, Badgett, rebound, scores! Colin Hussey on the power play. Breaks the shutout. The Growlers are on the board. And that, I believe, was 5-on-4, so I think that might end the power play altogether. We'll see if it comes off. Yeah, nobody in the box, so yeah, it's going to be back to 5-a-side. Second of the tournament for Hussey on the power play. Makes it a 6-1 game. They still have the penalty on the board, but there's nobody in the box. So unless there's a ghost that got a 2-minute minor, we are back to 5-a-side. And yeah, there are 5 max on the ice, so they just haven't taken the penalty time off the clock. Dooley, he's got 2 goals in this one. Now away comes Skinner. Philpott's dumped, hit his own blue line, and he's slow to get up. Up to his knee. Now he makes his way to the bench. Over the line, offside is Truen. He'll redirect that into the goal. That's not going to be popular. And Kirby comes out. Kirby wants a piece of Truen. And again, this is just frustrations boiling over for the Growlers. I told you Kirby was feisty. Well, in case you didn't believe me, you're seeing it now. Truen redirected that puck in after the whistle. Kirby came out, gave him a shot in the face with the stick or blocker or both, and then tried to punch him, and now Kirby's going at foot. Kirby is a feisty customer. Kirby's screaming at the referees right now as they discuss this. Truen's in the box. Truen's basically of the attitude, why me? What did I do? But Kirby most certainly should be penalized. Still no Growlers in the box. Still no Growlers in the box. Are they going to just call Truen for that? I mean, regardless of what preceded it, when a goaltender cross-checks someone up in the head area and then tries to punch with the blocker over the top, it's got to be penalized, doesn't it? Now the official's going to come down and probably have a word with Kirby. Tell him to mind his temper. Yeah, Philpott coming across now, so that makes more sense. Could never be just one penalty on that. Just one on the board right now. I think they're putting the other one up as we speak. I mean, you don't want to go over the top and cost your team, but I tell you, I'm a fan of that Scott Kirby feistiness in the goal. I've played against goaltenders and with goaltenders who were like that, and as long as you don't take it too far, as long as it doesn't affect your own game. Well, still no other penalty on the board, so I don't know what's going on. Philpott is in the box for the Growlers. Maybe he got the extra one. Maybe Kirby got the extra one, so it's a power play for the Max. 5-on-4. Fourth power play of the day for Halifax. Lindsay to Apong. London Apong. Down low. Perhaps a double minor to Kirby and just the single minor to Truen. We'll get the announcement here in a moment. Lindsay's shot hits something on the way in, and Schlender buries the rebound off the carom off the end boards. Tell me where you've heard that before. Another hard carom off those end boards. Power play goal for Halifax from Schlender. And it's 7-1. Gonna have to fire up the old game shit here. Two minutes for leaving the crease, 2 minutes for roughing to Scott Kirby. And then Truen with the minor for unsportsmanlike conduct. But that was then, and this is now. Schlender scores on the power play to end that. So coming up on the halfway mark of the third now, Max out in front 7-1, and suffice it to say, the Steel Subaru U18s are not going to get the help that they need from, take your pick, the Max or the Growlers or both. Getting the goal announcement for the Schlender goal now. Lindsay and Hines with the assists on the Schlender power play goal. I think that's Schlender's second. Yeah, it's his second of the tournament. And now I've got to get the particulars on the Hussey goal for you. So much work for one man, I tell you. Dobbin has it behind the goal. After a tournament where we had pretty much every game a one or two goal game, the last couple have kind of got away from teams a little bit. Or at least, sorry, two of the three games today. The last one, not so much. Hussey from Avery and Knight on the power play. That's the Growler's goal. Past the halfway mark of the third, Halifax 7. Pinnacle Growlers 1. Penalty coming now to Halifax. You figure these third periods, like in games like this, typically start to slow down, grind to a bit of a halt, and that's what we're seeing here now. Tripping to Walters. So off he goes. Seventh power play of the day for the Growlers. They're 1-for-6 so far. Maloney down low to Hussey. He's got the Growlers goal in this one. Maloney down low to Hussey. Walks out from the corner, sends it over here near side. That hits a stick and goes behind Avery. And now they'll have to clear. 20 seconds gone on the power play. Avery gets up ahead of steam over the blue line now. Nolan Avery stops. Sends it back here near point to Devereaux. Shot hits Truen in front. And now Truen will just clear it out over the blue line. Nick Devereaux drops it back to Maloney. 9 minutes to go in the third. Devereaux gets around Chip. Now he gets around Hartland. Devereaux shot blocked again by Truen. Truen, that's two good blocks for him here on this man advantage. Maloney, far side, looking for Andy Knight. Down low, Truen and Hussey battle. Hussey takes that from Logan. Gets it over to Knight, far side. Minute gone in the penalty. 1 minute to go on the Growlers power play. Centering pass! What a save from Maggett off of Avery. Avery got a stick in the face as well. That goes uncalled. Hussey to Knight. Looked like he was trying to leave it to go back to the point, but it got caught in his feet. Then he has to battle Chip. Hussey to Knight. Now this is taken away. Ripped by Truen off glass and out. 30 seconds remaining in the power play for the Growlers. Kirby way out in the corner, as he so typically does. Gonna stick it out a little bit. Now drops it for Gillespie. 37 saves for Scott Kirby in this one so far. Shot from Proctor. There's save number 38. 10 seconds to go in the Growlers' power play. Looks like the Macs are going to kill this one off. Skinner brings it ahead. Drops it to Philpott. Philpott shoots. That just goes wide of the far post. And now Walters comes out of the box. Penalty is over. 1-for-7 today on the power play are the Growlers. That's something they may lament. Proctor. Chip, sorry, Dooley. Fans on that wrister. He's got two goals in this one. Proctor has that knocked off his stick. Philpott there to pick it up. Philpott over the red line, over the blue line now. Philpott to Skinner to Reed Chafe. Shot save, rebound. Skinner tries to fire it on goal. Went off the side of the net. Maggett did good work there. Schlender. Easton Schlender, he's got the most recent Halifax goal. Goes to the net, shot right along the ice. Stopped by Kirby. Skinner. Over to Nathan Pilgrim. He'll send that deep. And now as Maggett comes out to play it, we get an offside. Sorry, an icing call. Icing call. They're now telling some players for the Growlers to get back on the ice as they had started a line change. Got the magnifying glasses out a little bit on that one. 45-21, the shots on goal in favor of Halifax. 6:41 to go in the third. Max in control, leading at 7-1. not looking back on their way to the finals tomorrow. Wagner keeps this in at the point. That bounces down on Kirby. He gloves it on the backhand like a shortstop and holds it. You see there on your screen, 6:32 to play in the third. How does a Max and Wild Atlantic Championship final sound? Sounds all right to me. Probably doesn't sound great to the Steel Subaru U18s and their fans. Foot now. Centers this. That's off of a leg, and that comes out into neutral ice. Creelman races back for it. So over to Shearer. Foot. Shearer. Pinned to the wall. Kane's working down there with him. Schlender. Shoots. That goes up and over the glass and into the netting and out of play. 6:03 on the clock. You look at Tim Boyce here to my left, Halifax coach, normally. Not behind the bench this week, though. Tim does good work. He's a good hockey man. Kearley. Wrist shot, blocked away by Magic. Chafe redirected by Keynes to the far corner. Apong. Chafe steps in front of that. O'Brien shoots that wide. Tucker sat down low. Now Chafe sends it in. Truman sends it back out. Chip over the line. Walters drags the skate. So I guess, I'm just thinking in terms of my question I asked earlier, does Tony McCarthy shorten the bench a bit? 7-1, 5:15 to go. I mean, Walters is out there right now. Chip's out there right now. We haven't seen Lindsay in a bit. I guess Lindsay, Legere, Marmolak, yeah, they're all in the middle. So maybe we won't see those three at least the rest of the way. Yeah, Lindsay's to the left of Nathan Mills, so he's beyond the door, so he might be done for the day. Again, it's just the smart thing to do, really. Not that I'm trying to coach somebody's team for them, but, I mean, these guys know what they're doing. These guys are smart hockey guys. Boland to Tucker. Proctor over to Dooley. In snapshot, Kirby takes a chunk out of that with the glove. Under 5 to go in the third now. God willing, my voice holding up. We'll be here at 1 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. Boland. Ahead to Tucker. Boland pulls that around Hines. 3-on-2 if they hurry. Boland. That hits the skate of Tilly. Proctor chips it ahead for Luke Dooley. Devereaux. Growlers are changing, so Devereaux waits up. 4 minutes to go in the third. Devereaux across the middle, right on the tape of that's Avery. Quick shot. And second effort goes wide, and a heavy thud off the end boards. Schlender cuts inside. His day is not done. Foot pulls out to the forehand, gets over to Schlender on the far side. Schlender with a nice right-left move. Shearer skates that deep. He's rubbed out. Now that pass goes off of Hussey, goes right back to Knight. Andy Knight to Devereaux. Over here, Maloney takes that off the skate, battles with Turner, loses the battle, and Truen skates it out. Gets the red line, sends it deep. Kirby stays in the goal. Knight waits for it down there. Partner pass to Devereaux. Back to, well, Knight's going to let Maloney take it. 3 minutes to go in the third. 3 minutes to go in the Growlers' season. Knight. It's the red line. Sends it in. Stopped before it got to the net by Truen. He'll bank it right back out. Delayed offside here on the Growlers. So Truen takes his time in no rush to bring it ahead. Walters for Apong. The Max superfan wants another Go Max Go chant. Walters brings it ahead. Walters, snapshot right on, gloved and held by Kirby. Save number 41 for Scott Kirby. Will he get his Player of the Game award today? I know what the optics look like. Same thing I said yesterday. It's hard to give someone a Player of the Game who's allowed 7 goals. And maybe it will end up being Hussey with the Player of the Game for having the single tally for the Growlers. But man, oh man, what would the score be but for Scott Kirby? That's my case. For the Max, take your pick. Luke Legere. Luke Dooley. Chip. Walters. I would say Walters or Legere. Here's Hartland now. Snapshot, block it away, and that almost went right on foot stick for a rebound goal at the side. 1:40 to play. Gillespie. Skinner. To Creelman. Proctor. Knight. Cross to Avery. Lifts it in wide of Magic. Magic will play it away from Hussey. Hussey looking for a second. Don't think he's going to get it today. Now Dobbin overskates it, or underskated it more accurately. Proctor takes it off the skate. Under a minute to play in the third. Hussey. Trying to reverse that. Now he'll try and bring it forward. Dooley takes that from him. Dooley tries to get it to Proctor. Dooley banks it back to the point. Truen walks in. Wrist shot. That goes wide. Off the carry out the end boards. They score. Hussey with a little bump for Dooley, and he goes flying. Well, this might clinch the Player of the Game award for Dooley. This is his hat trick. And it's 8-1 Max with 35 seconds to go. Third of the game and third of the tournament for Luke Dooley. No penalty to Hussey after that fact, and that's rightfully so. Proctor and I believe Apong with the assists. Proctor and Apong with the assists. Hat trick for Dooley. 5 seconds left. They tick the time down. The Halifax Max start the tournament with a loss. Storm back with 3 straight wins and qualify for tomorrow's Atlantic Championship final, where they'll take on the Kensington Wild. 8-1, the Max over the Growlers this afternoon here from East Hants. We'll stay with you for the Player of the Game presentations for each side. Max not only clinch a berth in the final, but they do it with authority. 8-1, leaving no doubt. Got a feel for the Steel Subaru U18s, and again, I'll wait till after the post-game presentations to break it down, but it, I tell you, Steel Subaru is not going to feel any better. About what happened. Teams are lined up on their blue lines waiting for the players of the game. Growlers finish up the tournament 0-4. Man, oh man, as I look at the standings here. It'll show you the tight margins of this tournament. If you don't believe me, I'm about to tell you once these player of the game presentations are over. Player of the game for the Growlers. Connor Hussey, like I said. They won't give it to someone that allowed 7 goals. So they give it to the lone goal scorer. And Luke Dooley with the player of the game for the Max. So, just before we sign off for the round robin, again, let me break down how this went for you. So, looking at the final round robin standings, this 3-point win for the Max vaults them over Steel Subaru. So they finish 1 point ahead of Steel Subaru in the standings for second place. Kensington first with 10 points. We knew they were going to the final as the home team. Halifax ends up 3-1, 9 points. Steel Subaru 3-0-1-0, 8 points. The difference between these two teams, 1 point, and that 1 point was an overtime win for Steel Subaru against Kensington instead of a regulation win. And you remember back the other night, Steel led 1-0 against Kensington in that game. Eddie Doyle scoring the tying goal with less than a minute to go to send that game to overtime. A 3-point win instead of a 2-point win there for Steel might have painted a different picture. Now, what I will say is the head-to-head tiebreaker between the two teams, Halifax had that by virtue of their win over Steel, so it may not have mattered. But again, it just illustrates to you how tight the margins are in this tournament, how close these standings were always going to be at the top. So that's my eulogy on that. And the Steel Subaru U18s, great tournament for them, though, nonetheless, great season for them. Nova Scotia finalists and a great showing here as the hosts at this great event. Good luck to all the graduating players on the Growlers as well, on the Moncton Flyers as well. So that's going to do it for us. The round robin is complete. 5 teams started, 2 teams remain. 1 p.m. Atlantic time tomorrow here, Keith Miller Arena inside the East Ham Sportsplex, the Atlantic Championship Final. The Kensington Wild and the Halifax Max for all the marbles and a trip to the TELUS Cup in Member 2, April 22nd to 28 on the line. We'll be here on AO Live. Hope you are too, if you're not able to be here with us live in the building. Mike Barkhouse, on behalf of Ashton Rieke, we thank you for being with us today, all tournament long. 1 more to go. Time to heal up, rest up, get the vocal cords ready for a big one on tap tomorrow. We'll be back 1 p.m. Atlantic time Sunday, tomorrow afternoon, for the Atlantic Championship Final of the 2024 U18 AAA Atlantic Hockey Championships. Good night, everyone, from East Hants. We'll see you tomorrow afternoon.